We are foreigners here, and we should keep a low profile as long as we can. We have a reputation in Skyrim. Let us hope it has not reached this far for our own good. However, we aren't exactly inconspicuous. A giant wolf, a Khajiit rogue, a sorceress, and, well, an old legionnaire. Old. Far from it. But I am feeling it. These battles are beginning to weigh upon me. Nevertheless, we are here together. And information is what we need first. Let us begin our search. And the sun is setting. Good for us. What have you seen?
I don't recognize you. So I'll assume this is your first visit to Ravenrock, Outlander. State your intentions.
You assume correctly, and I apologize for my Khajiit friend. He was excited to be on dry land once again. I am looking for someone in particular. Goes by the name Barak. Do you know of him?
Mirak, I'm not sure that I do. Just remember, Ravenrock is sovereign territory of House Redoran. This is Morrowind, not Skyrim. While you're here, you will be expected to abide by our laws. Any questions?
Questions? No. But I will obey your laws. You do seem suspicious of visitors. I imagine tourism to such a place is not so common.
I have to be. As second counselor, the security of Ravenrock is my primary concern.
And security has been an issue?
This isn't exactly the city of Blacklight. We're on the frontier out here. We've had more than a fair share of troubles. After all we've been through together, I refuse to let Counselor Morvain down.
I see. Your titles, I've not heard them before. What do they mean?
Counselor Morvain is House Redoran's representative on Solstheim. As second counselor, it's my job to support him and make certain his rule is enforced.
I see. So Ravenrock is a Dunmar settlement then. Am I correct?
Ravenrock started out as an imperial settlement. The Empire decided to abandon it, just as my people were first setting foot here. They left the town a shambles. But when House Redoran took over, we turned it around and it became ours. And even if it's been a struggle to make this island livable, we're proud to call it home.
I see. Can't your work wait? Apologies. The City of Blacklight, you'd mentioned it before. I've never heard of the thing.
Your ignorance of our homeland doesn't surprise me. It's the capital of Morrowind. Been that way ever since Mournhold was sacked by the Argonians. I don't visit there often anymore, but we still get the occasional supply ship and visitors from there.
I see. I mean no offense. My station, while serving in the Legion, had me far away from Morrowind. But the Argonians invaded. I know little of the act.
Quite a while ago, yes. They cut a bloody swath across most of the southern region of Morrowind. Nobody seems certain why it happened. An attempted expansion? Revenge for the enslavement of their people? Or perhaps both? Whatever the case may be, thousands of Dunmen needlessly lost their lives, and many more were exiled from their homeland.
I see. Enslavement or a race will bring anger out in others, though. I'm sure you know. Very well, I appreciate your welcome. Know that we will not cause you any trouble.
Remember, we are watching you.
Let's get indoors. Or in a cave. Anywhere, just out of this.
I agree. The sun is setting. Won't be long, however.
Before you even ask, yes, I Have the supplies you request.
Captain Gyalin does the business around here. I'm just a ship's mate.
I know.
But what?
This load cost me double what we'd agreed on. Nothing I can do about it.
Disagreements.
Damn it, Jollins, you know we don't have that much cost.
Let's leave them to it.
Look, the East Empire Company didn't get me
comfortable.
They've raised their prices again. And there's nothing
certainly
I can do about it.
Different.
After all these years,
good eve.
Every last trick we had.
Little seen armed of the like. Not for many years.
All right, Ashley. Don't worry about rushing.
Well, an intriguing settlement. A tavern is always a good start. If we can find one, we might be able to find answers, word of this Marak. I know his followers hail from here, and that official's reaction, he did squirm. No, he knows more than he's letting on. That I am sure of. Let us all be aware of him, and other eyes he may own. Now for a tavern. Surely a sign or some sort. We'll see what we can find. Smith. No need to use it, but it's good to know the same. Redguard. A fair mixture of cultures here. In this place, Ravenrock, I had heard of it. Although I did not know what had become of it. They were old legends, old tales. Used to scare Imperial children. Stories of wolves in the night. Well, at least now I know some of those stories might be true. All the same.
I'm no fan of the sun. It would be better than this.
Indeed. I find the air choked. This ash and mist. It's not to my liking, I can tell you that much. I'll try this larger structure. All of these seem more like homes. The guards aren't, well, talkative. No surprises. Let's see what we have here. Locked up. Another entrance, perhaps? It does seem official. If not a tavern, then perhaps some form of government. I don't suppose you can tell me anything,
Glover Mallory is a wonder with the old hammer and anvil. He mended me armor like an old pro.
I see. Well, should we require his services, I'll pass on the word. Not a tavern. Pardon my intrusion. It's a place of worship. I mean, not to disrupt. However, you may be able to assist me.
Are you here to pray? Or perhaps pay your respects at our ancestral tomb?
What are these tombs?
They're where we inter our dead. They are sacred places, meant to honor their passing. Sadly, we've been unable to use the ancestral tomb beneath the temple as of late, and have resorted to other locations to scatter the remains.
Unable to use them? Why not?
Those foul vermin, the abominations we call Ashspawn, have risen from the ashes of our own ancestors.
They're
befouling the memories of our forefathers by defiling their remains.
I am an agent of this.
Pardon my friend. You spoke of creatures of ash. I have seen similar things in the past. Perhaps I could assist you. Myself and my companions are more than capable. I'll cleanse this tomb for you in return for answers.
Thank you, Wanderer. That would be most kind. Here, this key should open the door to the tomb.
My thanks. I shall return once your tomb is safe.
Be cautious, friend. The Ashspawn are soulless beings with no regard for compassion.
I know a few of those back in Skyrim. All right. Down we go. He's grown since our last encounter, has he not? Don't worry. He doesn't bite.
Why do we rejoice that the tribunal has fallen and their false promises are but a memory?
There's a book. One moment. History of Ravenrock. No. No time to read. Now is the time for action.
Who are the Reclamations?
Straight ahead.
The Reclamations are Azura and
Kala. Leave them to their history lessons. Travel under. This is the spawn they spoke of. Stay ready to attack. Do not become surrounded. We know not their numbers yet. All right. More of them.
Who's there?
You.
They rise from the ashes. Watch out. Another. You're mine. Return them to ash. I hear more breathing.
Better run while you can.
I do not see them. There. You two have them. Well done. You hardly need to lift my blade. I forgot how good it was to fight alongside you all. We have not grown rusty in our time apart. But no doubt there will be more. What causes these creatures to rise forth? They call them abominations. Is this the act of an individual? Or something else? No sign of them yet. It does not mean they're not here. Much of the tomb seems undisturbed. I know not what causes them to rise. But if they do not, we shall carry on. Deeper in, if need be. Locked. Allow me a moment. Nothing as of yet. Drat. Yes, I'm sure you could do this much better, Arisa. There. Open. Not so nice. The outside. Not what we seek. However, if we should need another exit, we have one. Back inside for now. All the better for you and I. I don't want to be optimistic, but perhaps that is all there was. I'm surprised. They have guards outside. Surely they could have handled themselves against this. Regardless, if that is it, then we'll be able to get our answers. One here who knew of Marak, we will find them.
You were one of the Ashlanders, Elder?
I was.
Let us not interrupt.
I wandered the wastes of Varden, carrying the message of the reclamations from tribe to tribe. Don't you mean the anticipation? We no longer use that name, Fennel. They have reclaimed their identity and no longer represent the patronage of the false tribunal. You'll do well to remember that next time, attendant. Of course, Elder, please forgive me.
Elder.
I am Othraloth, Elder of the Reclamations and Keeper of this temple.
Yes, Othraloth, your tomb has been cleansed.
Spirits be praised. I'm hoping you didn't suffer much at the hands of those foul beings.
Please, accept this as a token of my thanks.
I thank you. I was not expecting coin. This will make my companions glad. But now I want information. Do you know of one called Marak?
Sounds like something from a dream, and yet it might be more strange.
A dream? What sort of dream do you speak of?
I remember a temple on Solstheim, and working to build something. It was not a pleasant dream.
A nightmare, then. Now, if that is all you know, thank you for your time.
May Azura, Mafala, and Boethia guide you.
Aye, and you. Dreams. I don't like the sound of it. I've encountered dreams before. In Dawnstar. This is not for Mina. No, this is not her work. Building something. This Marak has influence over these people. More than I thought. We should be careful with whom we speak. Drat. So they dreamt of a construction. Of something. I saw that structure on the way in. A bizarre one at that. Might be worth investigating. I've not seen a stone of its like. Still, a drink is in order. You've all learned it after that journey on that boat. It wasn't the easiest. Looks rather proper. Good eve.
Can't believe I've been stuck here this long.
Yes. Well, hopefully it comes to an end soon. Don't mind me.
Come on in. Let me know if you need it. Make a seat by the fire and I'll send someone over.
My thanks.
Find a seat. I will get us some food.
I would appreciate that. Warrior, might have a moment of your time.
I work for Mogrul. You got a problem, you talk to him.
Mogrul. Very well. My thanks, I'll have a word.
Making conversation. Next time you feel like having a conversation, talk to someone else.
Not the most approachable sort. Oh, where's that bartender? Good eve. We've been behaving ourselves, I'm sure you'd be happy to hear. Assisted one of your elders, in fact. Problem with their tomb, it would seem. Good thing for outsiders. A moment of your time.
Welcome to the Wretching Netch Corner Club, home of the finest Sioux jammer that will ever grace your lips.
The Wretching Netch. Quite the name.
There's actually a funny story behind the name, friend. A few years ago, I was walking down by the docks, and I noticed a Dunmer staggering along with a bottle of Sioux jammer in hand. He was one of my patrons and liked to drink heavily, so I wasn't exactly surprised.
I see. Doesn't sound unusual, however.
Ah, but you see, this particular Dunmer was as naked as the day he was born, and singing badly at the top of his lungs. As I'm watching this spectacle, a netch floats over the bulwark towards him. The man looks straight up at the netch, yells, "Have a drink," and tosses the bottle. And it never hit the ground.
Right, so this netch, what did it do?
Well, the bottle broke on the netch, and it must have swallowed its contents because it started floating sort of tilted. Finally, it stopped and began to quiver. A few moments later, the foulest liquid to ever assail your nostrils spewed from its maw. I've seen plenty of drunks in me day, and I'll tell you right now, that netch was sick.
Right, I'm glad I asked.
True story, friend. True story.
Very well. I'd like to know if you've heard any rumors as of late. Any strange tales?
If you've got gold on your hands, you might talk to Rallis at the Colbjorn Barrow. I've heard he wants to excavate the place.
Excavate? I see. Very well. I'll need a room for a time. For a number of us. I'll organize that now.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
My thanks. That's all for now.
I'll show you to your room, right this way.
Excellent.
Like I've requested. You and I both know we can't spare anyone right now. I don't care if you still have
after you.
Empire Company or not. They abandoned us long ago, so your contacts are meaningless here.
Thank you.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
I will. Room enough. Thank you. I'll purchase another for both yourself and Inigo. Serana and I, we do not need to sleep. We will spend the eve outside.
Three's a crowd.
Let me know. See Drayla with Captain Black.
It was a long journey. I don't trust him. The two of you should retire for the night. We'll come fetch you long before dawn.
He's twice her age and they barely know each other.
If we need to travel, it's best to do it while the sun is below the horizon.
You should be happy for
watch out for the wolf.
How about you keep serving the
all right.
And I'll decide.
Good eve, my friends. And to you, behave yourself. Nice to be just you and I again. These evenings, these nights. I wasn't able to say everything that I wanted to say back in the Grove. You shared much with me, and I still feel I need to share more. I despised you once. When we first met, I couldn't stand you. You were a vampire. Everything that I hated in this world. But I was blinded by that hatred. I did not see your compassion, your empathy for others.
I'm nothing if not persuasive.
That came in time. That night, you cared for me. Atop Fort Dawnguard. A place where all sought to kill you. You were there. Helping a werewolf through the night. You didn't need to. Yet you did. You stayed with me. You brought me calmness. You showed me a way to control what I am, to accept what I am. And that, if nothing else, is the greatest gift you could have given me. At least, I believed that. For a long while. But then, there was more. When I fell from Sovngarde, I fell into darkness. Yet somehow throughout it, I felt like you were with me. Like I never truly left you. I don't understand the influence your blood has, but I know you're not controlling me. No, you helped me. You helped me through that place. I believe it was you that brought me back. Not any call of destiny or honor or maneuver by the gods. It was the thought of you that allowed me to continue my fight. It was you that enabled me to escape. I still harbor scars of that place. The souls that are within me are fragmented. But somehow, you, your blood, you bind it all together. So, what I'm saying is thank you. If you had not come into my life, causing me hardship in the early days, no, I would not be the same. I would not be who I am now. So I am grateful.
I see. Somehow I knew you'd understand. Anyway, this is all very touching, but don't we have some more important things to worry about right now?
I don't know what this place holds for us, but that unease I felt back in Skyrim, I too feel it here. Something is not right with Nern. The world is shifting. In what ways, I know not. But we'll find that out together, eh?
Whenever you're ready.
I've talked long enough. I'll let you have your say. And then before dawn, wake the others. This Marak will have left a trace. We shall find it.